What's up, guys? Sammy Holt here, and it's been a really long time since I made an edited video for you guys. It's all been live streams lately. So here today, I'm going to show you guys the setup I used for basically all of 2014. I tweaked it a little bit for outdoors, but nothing serious. This setup still works really well for outdoors, and I loved it for Supercross, and I loved it for the FAMMX Supercross Fair series, whatever that was, the local series. A little bit more info for you guys. I've been posting a lot of videos on the This Is Def channel, which was owned by Nathan, if any of you guys watched it before. It still is, but Nathan's busy lately, so I've been keeping the channel active and such, so that's where about half my videos have been going. And this is kind of a special for, I'm about to hit 100 subscribers on this channel. I know that's like almost nothing really, but it's cool to know that it's growing a little and people are watching, and people actually care what I have to say sometimes. So anyways, we'll get right into the setup, and thanks guys. So to start off, stability, I know it doesn't really matter because advanced stability is what matters, but I have it at 30 anyways. Auto clutch, you want to have it 5,000. Brake torque, 460. Rear braking torque, 300. And then max dab speed, I like that at 27. Obviously, you should know all these, but arcade physics, no. Front brake, I like it on anti-lock. Rear brake, I like it on normal to kick the back end out sometimes. I stop wheelies in the front because I'm a goon and I can't brake all the time without wheeling. So, automatic shifting, no, obviously. I have dab one stop check for the start. Sticky sit dab, I like that because my button is weird. I don't like to have it realign after fall. If any of you are wondering what that means, it's like when you fall down and like your rider will like turn towards the next timing gate. This will disable that if you put that on no. Reverse steering, yes. And then I don't like to see the lane indicator. Let's get into suspension. Fork compression dampening, I have it at 83. Fork rebound dampening, I have it at 86. Fork spring rate, I have it at 80. Fork preload, I have it at 24. Fork oil level, I have it at 81. And then for the shock compression dampening, I have it at 43. Shock rebound dampening, I have it at 85. Shock spring rate, I have it at 35. Shock preload, I have it at 38. And for my gearing, I like it at -1.1. I feel like it's stable for me. A lot of people like it at -1.0, but it's your choice. See what works better for you. I like it here. For the rider settings, if you're used to riding one way, this might be really weird for you and different, but it's kind of how I get a lot of pop off of jumps, and I like it. But like I said, if you change these, it's going to feel probably drastically different from whatever you're riding right now. But anyways, the vertical spring is 81, vertical dampening 61, forward spring 87, and forward dampening 61. And I like my mass distribution at 0.46 to get a little higher center of gravity for the whoops. So we'll go into stability, and before I go into stability, I want to say first that changing your stability, like even more so than changing these four options, changes how you feel in the game. So if you change these, it's going to feel completely different. So I want to warn you that you might just want to try the suspension first and before you change anything in stability. Leveling, I think most people have it at 25. Almost everyone I've ever talked to has it at 25, but I have it at 25 also. Roll dampening, I have it at 62. Roll limit angle, I have it at 81. Roll limit factor, 31. Steering dampening, 38. Steering strength 100. I like full steering strength on it. I like a lot of steering force also, so I have that at 850. Direct steering, of course, at 1, fully direct. Slow dampening, I have 51. Slow dampening factor, I have it 2.25. Landing dampening fall off, I have it at 0.19. Landing dampening factor at 1.25. And then this full lock stuff is new to me, but I've had a lot of friends recently tell me to change mine from what I had it during Supercross, and I like this a lot better. I just recently changed this like a couple weeks ago. But anyways, full lock speed is 8, restricted lock speed is 53, and I have the restricted lock angle at 8. So that's going to do it for the entire setup. Hope it helps you guys out. It's a pretty stable setup that a lot of you probably aren't used to using. I like it a lot. It works good everywhere for me, every type of track. I've never really changed it except outdoors. I changed the gearing to get a little more high speed instead of acceleration. But thanks guys for watching. Thanks for reaching that 100 subscribers, which like I said is like nothing, but it's cool. And check out This Is Def channel. That's where I'm posting a lot of my videos lately, and we're streaming a lot there. Thanks for being a subscriber. Thanks for watching. Hope it helps you out. I'll see you guys later.